to make pivot query, we declare two column, one is pivot column, another is query. So here we will select the comma separated columns, I mean pivot columns. So this query will show the comma separated table data. So here we are showing actually the output, comma separated output for to assigning the pivot variable. So showing the output, we actually assigning this output to the pivot variable. So in pivot variable actually we use two table, you can also use one table. So table we use to show the comma separated value. Actually this is salary breakup table. Another table we have salary detail. In salary detail there it has employee ID for every employee. We have lot of entries for employee ID, we have a salary breakup ID. So we actually will distinct the salary breakup ID for all employee. Pivot table will show the heads in the dynamic column, right? So pivot table will only show the dynamic columns. So our output is expected is like this. So here actually we are showing the columns of pivot tables, dynamic columns by comma separated. Then we will actually select this, we will actually use this data inside the query. See, this is comma separated columns. So now the second one is the pivot column consist data, right, in comma separated. So we will use this comma separated data inside the second query. So actually in query variable we are making a query where we join employee salary, salary detail and breakup, salary breakup, right? So by joining this, we only selecting the heads that employee has value. So for this we are making a table, right? So we joined actually two table, one is salary breakup, another is another is employee salary. So by joining these two table, we are actually selecting only we required columns. So now select this now we actually use the salary breakup amount as to sum, and the breakup name, breakup name mean heads name, to show in a dynamic column, right? So here see, if you see, we only selecting three columns, one is amount, another is employee ID, and another is salary amount, right? So actually in salary amount we are doing sum, in breakup actually this breakup name we are using in the dynamic column. So and also the pivot column, it consists that all the dynamic columns. So if it is matched, then it will show this table. This is our expected output and this is the output, right? So if you see, for each of employee all the heads are showing in the column level, and we actually only push the data if this employee has data on this specific head. This is the final output.